Hello everyone. In the previous video lesson, we have seen what is decimal number system and what is binary number system and how can we convert number from decimal number system to binary number system and vice versa. In today's video, we will see about octal number system and hexadecimal system. And then we will see how can we convert from octal number system to decimal number system and vice versa, and hexadecimal number system to decimal number system and vice versa. So let's start with octal number system. So as the name represents, octal means 8. So in this number system, we have 8 symbols. So what will be the 8 symbols? If I will start from 0, then what will be the 8 symbols? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So these are the 8 possible symbols that will be allowed in octal number system. So it is different from decimal number system in the way that in decimal number system we have 2 more symbols, 8 and 9, but in octal number system 8 and 9 is not allowed. Also, this number system is positional number system like decimal number system and binary number system. If I will swap the position of some characters, some symbols in a number, then the number will be changed. Like here I have written 1743, it will not be equal to 7314, although the symbols are same in both the numbers, but their position is different. Since the position is different, the number is not same. Let's move to our conversion of decimal to octal. So the conversion from decimal to octal will be same as that of binary conversion, decimal to binary conversion, but the difference will be of dividing number. So in converting a number from decimal to binary, we were dividing the number by 2 and we were writing the remainder aside the division. Similarly, while we are converting number from decimal to octal, what we have to do? We have to divide the number by 8 until we reach 0, and we have to collect the remainder in reverse order. So here we have an example, 214. It is a decimal number because here 10 is written. So if 10 is written, this is a decimal number system. So what I will do, I will start dividing this 214 by 8. So let's start dividing this 214 by 8. So 8 into 26, when 214 is divided by 8, it will yield a quotient 26 and a remainder 6. So I have written my quotient here and the remainder here. Now I will again divide this 26 by 8 because this 26 is not equal to 0. So I will again divide it by 8. Now 8 into 3 is equal to 24. So I have written quotient here and the remainder 2 here. Now 8 into 0 is equal to 0. The remainder will be 3. Now we have reached 0. So the process is over now. I can collect my remainder in reverse order. So what I have to do? I have to collect the remainder in reverse order. So the octal number will be 3, 2, 6. This is the resultant answer of the conversion. See here, 8 is written. So this 8 is signifying that this is a octal number. Now we will see how can we convert number from octal to decimal. Here I have this number 357. It is in octal number system and I want to convert it to decimal number system. So first we will write this number 3 5
the conversion method is same as Jado binary to decimal, but the only thing different is the number 8. We have to use the number 8 in place of 2. So what we have to do, we have to write the position number 0, 1 and 2. So this is the position number and this is the power octal number. So what I will do, I will write 3 into 8 to the power 2 plus 5 multiplied by 8 to the power 1 plus 7 into 8 to the power 0. So the conversion method is same as that of binary to decimal, but we are using here 8 in place of 2. Rest of the thing is same. So I will solve it and this will become 8 to the power 2 will become 64, which we have written here. 5 into 8 to the power 1 will be equal to 5 into 8, which I have written here. 7 into 8 to the power 0, 8 to the power 0 will be reduced to 1, so it will become 7 into 1. When I will solve this, it will convert to 192, it will convert to 40 and it will convert to 7. Then I will sum them all and I will get the number 239. So this is the resultant decimal number. So I hope that this one is clear to you. In this method, it is also the same thing which have been done here. So what they are doing, they are just writing 8 to the power 2, 8 to the power 1, 8 to the power 0, and then they are calculating these values and then they are directly multiplying them. So instead of writing in this way, they are directly writing it. So both are same, you can adopt any one of the method. So let's move forward to hexadecimal number. Now we will start hexadecimal number system. So what is the meaning of hexadecimal? Hexadecimal is comprises of two words, hexa and decimal. So hexa means 6 and deca means 10. So 6 plus 10 will be equal to 16. So in this number system, we will be having 16 symbols. So what are those 16 symbols? So we will take the first 10 symbols from the decimal number system. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9 are being taken from decimal number system. But what next? From where we will get the remaining 6 symbols? So we will take the next 6 symbols from the English alphabets. So the first 6 symbols of English alphabets are A, B, C, D, E and F. So these 6 will be added to the hexadecimal number system. So now we are having 16 symbols in hexadecimal number system from 0 to 9 and from A to F. Also, hexadecimal number system is a positional number system, which means that the value of digit depends upon its position. Like if I am writing this D in unit place and if I am writing it this G in 100 place, then both are different. If I will change the position of the symbol, then the value of the number will change. So this is a conversion of decimal to hexadecimal. So like you can say that 0 in decimal will be equal to 0 in hex, 1 in decimal will be equal to 1 in hexa, 2 in decimal will be equal to 2 in hexa. Similarly, up to 9, both will be same. But since we are saying that we have 16 symbols in hexadecimal and we have only 10 symbols in decimal number system, so the next 6 numbers from 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. These will be represented by A, B, C, D, E, and F. So the 10 in decimal will be equal to A in hexadecimal, 11 in decimal will be equal to B in hexadecimal, 12 in decimal will be equal to C in hexadecimal, 14 in decimal will be equal to E in hexadecimal, and 15 will be equal to F. So this table will be required when we will convert number from decimal to hexa and hexa to decimal. So you should know these last six numbers. So first 10 are same, 0 to 9 will be same as that of decimal number system, but in hexadecimal number system from 10 to 15 we will represent them by A to F. We will not write 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. We will write A, B, C, D, E, and F in case of 10. So let's start with conversion of decimal number system to hexadecimal number system. Now we will see how can we convert decimal number to hexadecimal number. So we will convert from decimal to hexadecimal number system. So the method will remain same as that of decimal to binary and decimal to octal. What will change? The dividing parameter will change. In decimal to binary, we were dividing by 2. In decimal to octal, we were dividing by 8. So in decimal to hexa, we will divide by 16. So let's take first example. So let's take number 30. So I want to convert this 30 into hexadecimal number system. This is a decimal number. So what I will do? I will divide it by 16. So I will divide it by 16 and I will collect the remainders, and then we will write all the remainders in reverse order. So 16 multiplied by 1 will be equal to 16, leaving over remainder 14, and then 16 multiplied by 0 will be equal to 0, leaving over remainder 1. So now we have reached 0. So the procedure is over. I can collect the remainder from the reverse order. So we have remainder 1 and 14, but I cannot write it as 114, because I have tell you one thing, that in hexadecimal number system 14 will be equal to E. We have discussed that A will be equal to 10, B will be equal to 11, C will be equal to 12, D will be equal to 13, E will be equal to 14, and F will be equal to 15. So the number will be 1. In place of 14, I will write E. So this is my hexadecimal number. I can write as 1 E base 16. So I hope that this one is clear to you. Let's take one more example. Let's take 3. So 16 multiply 3 will be equal to 48, leaving over remainder 2, and then 16 0 will be equal to 0, leaving over remainder 2. So 50 in decimal will be equal to 32 in hexadecimal. So I hope that this conversion is clear to you. So this is how I can convert from decimal to hexadecimal number system. So you can try more examples by yourself. Let's move to hexadecimal to decimal. In hexadecimal 2, decimal conversion, the conversion process will be same as that of octal to decimal and binary to decimal. But the thing that will change will be the number by which we will multiply the numbers. Let's see this with the help of an example. So let's say we have one hexadecimal number A2. So A2 is a valid hexadecimal number. So I can write it as A2 in 16. So 16 represents that it is a hexadecimal number. I want to convert it into decimal number system. So to convert it into decimal number system, what I have to do? I have to write 0 and 1 here. Now what we will do? We will multiply A with 16 to the power 1 plus, let's keep this in bracket, plus 2 into 16 to the power 0. Now what we will do, we can't multiply A with 16 to the power 1. So what we have to do, what is the decimal value of A? 10. So we will write 10 into 16 and it will become plus 2 multiplied by 16 to the power 0 will be equal to 1, anything to the power 0 will be equal to 1. So now this will become 160 plus 2. Answer will be 162. So this will be base 10. So this is how you can convert from hexadecimal to decimal number system. You can verify this conversion, whether it is giving correct result or not, by again converting this decimal number to hexadecimal number. So I have written here 162 and I want to convert this 162 into hexadecimal number system. So to convert into hexadecimal number system, what I have to do, I have to divide it by 16. So when I will divide it, what it will give me? 16 into 1 will be equal to 16 and 0 will come here and remainder will be 2. So 16 into 10 is equal to 160, remainder will be 2. Again, I will divide it by 16, then it will be 16 into 0 will be equal to 16, remainder will be 10. So now what we will do, we will collect the remainder from downward to upward direction. So our number will be 10 and 2, but I can't write 10 as it is because it is greater than 9. So what I have to do, I have to convert it into hexadecimal. So 10 will be equal to A in hexadecimal and 2. So this is our hexadecimal number C. This number is same as this number. So you can see that our conversion was correct. Thank you.